Hello friends, welcome to our channel. So now we are going to discuss one. So go with a previous question. Subprime Fibonacci. So problem description. So given two numbers n1 and n2. So find the prime numbers between n1 and n2. This is the first task. Next, make all possible unique combinations of numbers from the prime numbers list. So unique combinations numbers from step 1. So third step, from this new list again find all prime numbers. Fourth step, find smallest number and largest number from the list. This is the list from this list. Also count of this list. So what is the counter? So consider smallest and largest numbers as first and second numbers to generate Fibonacci series respectively till the count. So print last number of a Fibonacci series as an output. So this is the sample input 240. So this is the output we get 131580066689. So how we get this number? We discuss later. So this is the large number. So same thing we can apply on by taking small n1 and n2 values. So this is the n1, this is the n2. So what is the first step? Find prime numbers. These are the prime numbers. So prime numbers between 2 and 10. Next, what is the second step? Make all possible unique combinations. Unique combinations means 2, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7. 3 2 3 5 3 7 5 2 5 3 5 7 7 2 7 3 7 5. Okay, so this is the second step. So combinations. So what is the third step? So you can identify the prime numbers in this list. So what are the prime numbers? 37 is the prime number, 73 is the prime number, 53 is the prime number, 23 is the prime number. Okay. So for that, we are going to find the smallest and largest value. So what is the smallest value? 23 is smallest. So what is the largest value? 73. 73 is largest. And so count. What is the count of the prime numbers? 4. The count equals to 4. Now we can print the Fibonacci series up to 4 numbers. So 23 is the small number 1, 73 is the second number 2. So what is the third number? 23 plus 73, 96. So what is the fourth value? 73 plus 96, 169. So that's it. Now what we are going to print? Print last number of a Fibonacci series. What is the last number? 169. So this is the output if n1 equals to 2 and equals to 10. Same like that, if you are giving n1 equals to 2 and equals to 14, then the output is this is the number we got. Now we see the program for prime Fibonacci. So this is the input n1 equals to 2 and equals to 10. Here I am taking as a m comma n. That means m equals to 2, n equals to 10. I am taking a list to store all the prime numbers. So initially it is empty. We can divide this problem into 4 parts. So this is the part 1. To find the prime numbers. So this is the part 2. To find combinations. So this is for prime numbers. So this is for combinations. So same code for to find prime numbers. And fourth one, to find Fibonacci. Fibonacci series. So these are the four parts. So first part, to find the prime numbers within this range inclusive of both the values. Next, find the combinations for these prime numbers. Next step, find the prime numbers in the combinations. Next step, you are going to find the Fibonacci series. Now we can see with the example. So m equals to 2, n equals to 10. For I in range of m comma n plus 1, what is the m value? 2. So m plus 1 means 10. That means the range is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that means, so these are the numbers between 2 to 10, inclusive of 2 and 10. Now we are going to find the prime numbers in these numbers. Okay, so I equals to 2 first. So j in range of 2 comma, so int of math sqrt of I, already we discussed in our previous examples. So this is for to reduce the time complexity. So that means, for example, I want to find the 100 is prime number or not. For that, we are not doing the operations from 2 to 99. Just you can find the square root of 100, 10. And you can perform the operations from 2 to 10. If this number is not divisible by these numbers, means we say that the 100 is prime number. So how we can reduce the iterations means by using square root. By using the square root, we can find we can reduce the time, execution time. Okay, so 2 comma int math square root of I plus 1 means it's also become square root of 2. That means 1 point something. So that means, and we cannot enter into this loop. So else L dot append of I. What's I? 2. So next it becomes, I becomes 3. J in range of 2 comma int of square root of 3. That means 2 point something means 2 comma plus 1 3 means 2 comma 2 1. So in this case also we don't enter into this block. L dot append 3. Next I becomes 4. So 2 comma square root of 4. Square root of 4 means 2. 2 plus 1 means 3. So 2 comma 3. So that means 2. So j equals to 2. So what is the I value? 4 percentage 2 equals to 0. Yes, it is true. So break. We don't append the 4 into L. Go to here. Now I becomes 5. So int of math.sqrt of 5. Okay. So sqrt of 5 means we got 2 point something. So that is integer means 2. 2 plus 1 means 3. So 2 to 3. That means 2. So I value equals to 5. Percentage 2 equals to 0. False. So next I, there is no only one iteration. So else append I. 5. Next case 6, the condition is true, not appended. If I equals to 7, so math sqrt of 7 means sqrt of 7 means 2 point plus 1 means 3. 2 comma 3 means 2. 7 percentage 2 equals to 0, false. So enter into this append. Same like that, 8 is when 8, the condition is when I becomes 8, the condition is true, so not appended. So for 9 also not appended. For 10 also not appended. So this is the list. After completion of this, so what are the elements in L? L equals to 2, 3, 5, 7. So now we are going to find the permutations. So by using these permutations predefined function, we are going to find the permutations. So permutations of L comma 2. So L is 2, 3, 5, 7, comma 2. So that means, so two combinations, 2, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7. These into one permutation. And second one, 2, 5 is one permutation, 2, 7. So that means, what is the T? T equals to list, in this list, 2, comma 3, 2, comma 5, 2, comma 7, 3, comma 2, 3, comma 5, 3, 7, 5, 2, 5, 3, 5, 7, 7, 2, 7, 3, 7, 5. So this is the list T. So now we are combine these two, 2, 3, 25, 27, like that. So how? I am taking on empty list W. So in this W, I am going to store I and T. What is the T? First I becomes 2, 3. I have 0, 2, I have 1, 3. String, I convert into the string. And again, that is converted into the int and store in z. The z is appended. That means 23. Next iteration, 25. Next iteration, 27. Next, 32. 35. 37. 52. 53. 57. 72. 73 and 75. So this is the W, second step, the combinations of these values. So 2, 3, 2, 5, 2, 7. Okay, the next step is you are going to find the prime numbers in this list. Prime number in this list, same code. Here the input is 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. Here the input is W. So that's the only change if you observe that. Here we can store the so prime numbers in H. I am taking H, an empty list. So W is list of set of W. What that means, if there is any duplications, they are specifying in the problem, find the unique values. If there is any duplication, we can reduce. How we can reduce the duplications means by converting this W into set. If there is any duplications, those are eliminated. And again, it is converted into the list. So after that, the same thing. So 23. So 23 is prime number or not? Yes, it is prime. So 25? No. 27? No. 32? No. 35? No. 37? Prime number. 52? No. 53? Yes. 53 is prime number. 57? No. 72? No. 73 is prime number. 75? No. So this is the prime number. This is the third step. You are finding the prime numbers in this list. So next, find the length of H. What is the length? It's to 4. That means we are going to find the Fibonacci series up to 4 terms. So I am taking an E. In this E, you are going to store the Fibonacci series. This is the E. Let us assume. E dot append. So min dot H. What is the minimum value in this H? 23. E dot append, max of H. What is the max of H? 73. So for last step is you are finding the Fibonacci series. So E of I minus 1. That means for I in range of 2 comma R. So that means 2. What is the R here? 4. That means 2, 3. That means this is the 0th index. This is the 1 index. You can store the values from second index. So E dot append, I minus 1. What is I value? 2 minus 1. That means 1. E of 1 plus E of 0. So that means these two. 96 happened here. Next iteration, I becomes 3. 3 minus 1 means 2. So 3 minus 2 means 1. So these two. So what is the output? 169. So after that, no, only two iterations. So that's it. Print E of minus 1. What is the last number? So how we can access the last element in the list? E of minus 1. What is the E of minus 1? 169. So that is the output. If we give input 2, 40, we get this number. 131580006689. I hope you all are understand the prime Fibonacci.
So now we see the execution of the program. We give the input 240. So this is the output. We can check with 2 and 10. So 2 and 10, it returns 169. So you can download this program from description.